Hey guys, what's up? I'm back in another video and today we are unboxing this Hot Wheels 5-Pax Exotics. So let's get started. So the contents are Pagani Huayra Roadster, Lamborghini Sesto Elemento, Lamborghini Gallardo LP570-4 Super Leggera, Lotus Esprit S1 and Aston Martin V8 Vantage. So let's crack these open. Yep, so the first car is the Pagani Huayra Roadster. Next car in this set is the Lamborghini Sesto Elemento. I like this decal on this car. The wheels are nice. Okay, so this way. Spoiler looks great. So the next car in this set is another Lamborghini. Is the Lamborghini Gallardo. This car looks good as well. I like this bumper part and the logo came out pretty clean as well. Also, another thing I like is the texturing here at the plastic. It's clear at this part, but then it's rough on the edges, you can see, and you can also see the engine inside if you look closely. So the back looks pretty clean, nice decal. Yeah, so the next car is the Lotus Esprit S1. So I wasn't very excited about this car. It's okay, like it's all flat yellow, like the base is yellow, the main body of the car is yellow, but the wheels look really really cool. Like these are like the basic Hot Wheels wheels, like we have seen this a lot of time in like almost every car. So this is something new. I like this. So you can see Esprit written over here, not very clean. So the very last car in this set is the Aston Martin V8 Vantage. This is a pretty decent car. I really like it a lot. And the decals are very clean on this car. Very, very clean. And the wheels look pretty cool as well. Also, I had a complaint about this car because the decal right here, it's not in the center. You see, and a black tiny splotch over the red part. Yeah, just a minor gripe. So yeah, looks pretty cool. So now for the comparison, I'll be comparing this car to the same version, but it's a different color and it's a single car. Yeah, it's in the mainline packaging, but Exotic series. So let's take this car out. Yeah, so it's pretty much the same car. Let me look from the back, but here you can see that the font of the Huayra written over here is way bigger than the one on the older version. Like not really that old, but yeah, this came in the 5-pack. This was the single car, and the tail lamps look pretty cool on both the cars actually, but I like the wheels more. It's pretty much the same wheels, but the color. And also you can see this decal right over here on this car. You do not see that on this one. Yeah, oops. But you get this decal right over here. It's pretty plain on this car. There's also the front lights are not painted. What do you call them? Headlights, yeah. They are not painted on any of the car. Both of the cars are plain colored. Like, come on, Hot Wheels. Yeah, so oops, that's the comparison for the Pagani Huayra Road. So I'll be comparing the Lamborghini Sesto Elemento with the Lamborghini Aventador, because I think that the front part looks pretty similar, you know. Like, you can just have a look. Like, there's not so much to talk about it. But one thing I liked about this car is, yeah, you know, see, oh shit, it's not staying still. You can see that the tail lamps are in plastic. Yeah, it's like, unlike this one, they are all in metal, like just one mold. And I will be comparing this Lamborghini Gallardo with the Lamborghini Murcielago. Oops, right here. I'll just take this out. Yep. So the difference is this car looks bigger than this one. Like, they look pretty out of scale. Like, okay, it still works, but come on, this one looks so bigger. But this one has like decals on the side. This one has it on the front part. You can see this plastic on both the cars. This one has painted tail lamps, plus you can see Lamborghini written right over here. Okay, let me get the camera to focus. No, it's not. So yeah, that's the comparison for Lamborghini Gallardo. So this car will be compared by two different cars. Yeah, from the same brand, of course. It would be by the Lotus Esprit, which came with the Exotic series, same like the Pagani Huayra. And also I'll be comparing this with the Lotus Esprit. So these two are the Lotus Esprit S1, and this is only Lotus Esprit. So the real difference is that this car looks more big and does not actually look like a sports car, but it has a spoiler on it. This one looks very different. It has that, you know, curve to a car, like how you see on a sports car. See? So let's compare first these two side by side. So I like the wheels better on the new one, in the sense the 5-pack. But yeah, so actually on the other one as well, it's just two same colors on like both the sides. Like, we have flat yellow and yellow here, it's like orange and orange again. They should have changed for this plastic portion for the base. So the bumper looks pretty okay. Yeah, but the decals were not in a good condition. Like, it was just like that when I bought it. Same happened with this car. You can see some tiny splotches right over here, and then the same thing happening on this side. It's not even, the Esprit is not written pretty nicely actually. Same with this car. But one thing I like more about this car is that you can see these tail lamps and the number plate painted on this car, but not on this one. It's just flat. You can see it on this one. Okay, let me come and close up. Yep, so you can see HWC 1968 and then these three colors. So yeah, pretty cool. Oops, I keep dropping these cars. Yeah, so now we'll be comparing these two cars side by side. Let me keep this car back into its packaging. Yeah, so these two are very different cars. Very, very different. but we can see the Lotus logo on this one. Yeah, but there's nothing, like, you can see the circle over here, but there's no logo on it. Yeah. So that was the comparison for Lotus Esprit S1. And now we'll be moving to our last car. Okay, so as you can see, for the Aston Martin V8 Vantage, I have these two different Hot Wheels models to compare to. This is the Aston Martin 177, and honestly I don't know which one this is, because I tried looking for the name on this plastic side, but I did not find anything. Come on. So let's start comparing this. First I'll be comparing it with Aston Martin 177, and these two are very different cars, because, like, you know, see the shape and all, it's pretty different. But if you see the front part of both the cars, you can see some similarities. You see, like, this part over here, or the headlamps. The wheels are very awesome on this one. I like it a lot. Oh, but you can see the number plate on the Aston Martin 177. Why is this camera not focusing? I don't know. Okay, there you go. Looks pretty awesome. And now, this is the other Aston Martin. Yep. So, yeah, they look pretty similar. I told you, the front part of the Aston Martins, they look very similar. And this car is actually very similar. No. I think it's the same car. Happy late realization. It's the same car. No, it's not. No, it's not. I thought it's the same car, but it's not. It's not. It's not. Yeah. So that was the comparison for Aston Martin V8 one. So, if I have to rank these cars, the number one spot would probably go to the Lamborghini Sesto Elemento. Because this car looks pretty awesome, you know, like all these edges and sides to the car. The mold is pretty nice. The paint came out very clean. The Lamborghini logo and the headlights. Yeah, so the number one spot goes to Lamborghini Sesto Elemento. So, yeah, let's keep it in this order. So, the number two spot has to go to the Aston Martin V8 Vantage, because of these wheels. The decal came out the cleanest out of the five. And I like the look of this car, plus the blue looks really nice. So the number three spot goes to, it's very difficult actually. Okay, so it will go to this Lamborghini Gallardo, whatever it is. I forgot the full name. Lamborghini Gallardo LP570-4 Superleggera. A very long name for a car, but this car has made it to the number 3 spot due to those clean decals right over here. Plus you can see the Superleggera written, but I don't know if you can see it very clearly. Yeah, it's very tiny. And plus this part, you can see this small strip right over here is plastic but not metal, like it's bumping out. Looks real cool. Plus this rear part. And you can see the engine inside. Not very clearly, but yeah, you can see that inside over here. So this car has made it to the number 3 spot. The number 4 spot goes to this Pagani Huayra Roadster. As it is a better car than this one. Yeah, seriously. And the number 5, of course, goes to the Lotus Esprit S1. because it's my least favorite from the list. Very flat, not good decals enough. The text is not properly printed or painted, you can see. So yeah, this was my top 5 order of this 5 pack from Hot Wheels Exotics. So comment down which was your favorite car from this list. And if you like this video, share it, subscribe to my channel and give this video a thumbs up. And I'll see you in the next video. Bye.